from others, whether about like there is some kind of a negativity, or there is people are not that much sensitized, the paying tendency of the population is quite compromised. So before we start, I wish you all great luck, because you have just taken up an opportunity, because business is all about opportunities, and this opportunity about being a part of this orientation program, this is a very powerful free lecture series which I'm doing. I'm Ravi Shankar. I'm physical rehab analyst, business analyst and coach, and I'm CEO and founder of Start Exercises Physiotherapy Services. I'm based in Delhi, and great thanks for Dr. Prerak, Project Ask Physio, for just bridging up this. So before we start, I want you all to say, great work, Project Ask Physios, or great work, or you can even give a thumbs up, because we need to start this great session on the right note. So say, great work, Dr. Prerak, great work, Project Ask Physios. You can also use the thumbs up. So please use your keyboards, and it should start coming up, please. Yeah, Dr. Jagannath, yeah, great. Yeah, definitely, please, more. We need more inspiration. See, business is all about energy. Keep up your energy levels, please. Yes, Dr. Divya Thakur, yes, please. Dr. Reena, Dr. Shraddha, Dr. Sushma, oh, that's great. From the, yeah, Dr. Prabha Sobia, Varsha Zope. Great, great, great. Please go on, go on. Keep up your energy levels. Come on, come on. It's about business. We are going to talk about money, and money is all about energy levels. Yes, great thumbs up. Yes, from Farin Sheikh. Yes, great, great. So, Project Ask Physios, courtesy Dr. Prerak Arya, please, great work. And now, please go on, please go on. Don't stop. Please go on, go on. Dr. Danish Khan, yes, great, great. Absolutely, yes. All the power to Project Ask Physios. They have been doing great work, and it's a really great thing that this platform has initiated, kind of, inviting all these kind of different scenarios, all related to our profession. You earn, you know a skill, but how to earn better, how to make big money out of that skill is something we are going to talk today in the first part of a lecture series, which is about how to create a business in physiotherapy. And then we'll be looking forward to how to beat the competition and becoming a brand. Now, so that's a great lot. Thanks. Thank you for all your energy. And now, before we start, I want you all to say thank you for yourself, for being over here. So please, please, again, say yes, 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 because this yes is for you, that yes, I'm here. I made it. I did my adjustments, I had my routines, I took my time out, and I'm, yeah, yes, Dr. Jagannath, yes, please, 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 keep coming, yeah, Dr. Dipanjali, yeah, great, great, great. So, are you feeling energetic? Yes, yes, I made it, yes, you made through this station, yes, that's great. Dr. Kiran Madhav, Dr. Vivek, Anolisha, yes, yes, Dr. Prerak has been telling me there has been a lot of enthusiasm going on since last evening. So that's great. So I'll make sure you will be winning it, definitely. So just doing, yes, this yes is for yourself, Dr. Megha Bhoyari. This is for yourself. Yes, Dr. Sushma, yes, definitely. Please go on, say yes for yourself. Yes, that's the energy we need to set. Yes, yes, because physiotherapy is all about energy. Physiotherapy is all about regaining things. So why not about business? Money is a great power which comes. So definitely, Dr. Mary Munde, great, great, yes, yes, she has given, yes, Dr. Abdulaziz, yes, he has given, I give his, so I think it's all fizzing out. Sobia, yeah, great, yes, great. So great, thank you all for being over here, and so let us start for this powerful session with a bang, which is inside your head, how much money I can make out of physiotherapy, right? Am I audible? Are you comfortable listening to me? Say yes. Anyone? Am I audible? Clear? Okay, that's great. So, if you have any apprehensions, you must be thinking, okay, I'll be having a clinic. I'll be having a team of physios. I'll be a great coach for them. I'll be a great guide to them. That come to me. I'll provide you a career. I'll provide my great services to the society. You have a service at the clinic, you have a service in the home sectors, and you are planning that let me have a project where I can treat people in the community, you know, community thing. But then you are bogged down by the feelings like, oh, people don't want to pay. If I open up a setup, who will come and they will be asking for discount. There are so many different varied setups. There are so many different experiences. Quacks are there. There are people who are practicing in malpractice, and they're doing malpractices. So how am I going to sustain? Okay, let me first think about, okay, I'm at least having a, if I'm in a job, okay, I'm ensured that I'm having a ample takeaway for my home, and then I have some time left that I can see patients or I can visit some clinic either before my duty hours or after the duty hours. Or if you're having a clinic and then you see that the footfall of the patient and the outcomes are not generating enough revenues so that you can pay your EMIs, so that you can, you know, you can think of expanding your clinic. If you are a owner of a chain of clinics, like you said, then you have a problem that my employees, I don't know if I'm not there, if I'm not monitoring them very closely, I'm definitely going to lose my revenues because I don't know how come they're converting the leads, they're converting the inquiries, whether they're able to retain the patient within the system or not. Because you see the patients, we know that they require 2 months, 3 months of physiotherapy, but they discontinue after, say, 2 weeks, 1 week, 10 weeks. So all the focus is about how to make that patient renew the services, right? Dr. Dipeksha, am I audible? Dr. Dipeksha is not able to hear me. Am I audible, anybody? Hello? Okay, great. Okay, fine. So Dr. Dipeksha can be, yeah, please. So let us think about how many of us agree that physiotherapy is an expensive service. If you feel that, yes, physiotherapy is an expensive service, as expensive as a BMW, because people, they can, once they're admitted in a hospital, they know they are going to get discharged with a certain amount of bill. But what amount of money they are going to pay to a physiotherapist, whether for the initial care, whether for the home care, whether for the hospital care, whether visiting to a clinic, and further on for wellness level physiotherapy training. Do you think physiotherapy is an expensive service? Please say yes. If you don't agree, please say no. Okay, Dr. Girija Patil says physiotherapy is not an expensive service. Dr. Sobia, Dr. Abdulaziz, nope. Okay, that's great. So a lot of people are disagreeing that it is not an expensive service. So, okay, so Dr. Predak, hello?
Yes, sir.
Yes, so a lot of people are not agreeing to it that physiotherapy isn't expensive, okay? So let us, can we do a bit of calculation if we have some time over here? Like a patient on an average, how much do you charge in a clinic? Let it just give me any number, 200, 300, 400, give me any number. Say 600, 200, let us take 400. 400, let us take. So 400 for a patient, suppose he's requiring about 30 sessions. So how much it is? It's 12,000, right? 12,000, Dr. Jagannath. Rupees 300. So you see, it's all so varied. Now, if I ask you that, are you selling your prices at this price, or you are bound to give discount, or you offer, do you leave your consultation fees even before the patient asks for it? Do you have that kind of apprehension that, okay, for every new assessment, I might not be getting paid my consultation fees because the patient will offer that, okay, I'm taking your package, then please waive off the consultation fees. Is it happening? Please be honest. Businesses is a toothless tiger. It bites. Dr. Anulisha, yes, she practices great. Anulisha, Dr. Sushma Bhavna, no. Okay. So as for you, if physiotherapy is not an expensive service, then why it is being sold in that much quantity that hasn't left any physiotherapy clinic earning in crores. Is any physiotherapy making clinic making any net worth of 1 crore? Do you know anyone? Except I'm not talking about doing workshops and everything. Physiotherapy is an expensive service. Please note it down. Physiotherapy is not a cheap service. Please don't think, because it's not only the money, it's time, money, effort, pain, everything the patient goes through. What I told, when the patient goes to the hospital, corporate chains are different. Corporate chains are different, which are with hospitals. I'm talking about somebody who is having a clinic at a place, is having a team of doctors, is he or she making a net worth which is very great, very significant? Net means after all the expenses are done, it's very difficult. Yes, Dr. Manisha, this is really difficult. And do you think that every next year, whatever money you make, you learned a skill? If you talk about the time period before the lockdown, you learned a new clinical skill 6 months before. You learned a clinical, new clinical skill. You did, got a certification an year before. So did your revenues increase significantly because of that? Could you think that I learned this new technique so I can dedicate a new whole unit to this new skill which I have learned? And that will help me grow. It will help me multiply my clinics. It will help me multiply my team. Did it happen that any one of you say yes or no? Please, these are hard. This is about business. This is about business. Please be honest. Please be honest. Yes. Yes, please be honest. It doesn't happen. So the time, money, and your effort which you put through your workshops, through your certification. Hello. Hello.
Yes, sir.
Yeah, I'm audible now.
Yeah, yeah, perfect.
Yeah, that's great. That's great. Okay. So what I was saying, that whatever amount of money, time and effort you put through learning all those, with all those great trainers, did it make significant change in your life? Could you multiply your clinics? Could you think that I can create a really impactful team, a business out of this? Yes, it hasn't, because if it would have been, we would all have known. There are therapists who are having 5, 6, 7 clinics, but they could never think of going beyond 10 clinics, right? It's maximum 11 or 12. Do you have a dream? Now be honest with yourself. If we leave everything, improve our skills, but not just to improve our skills, but for what? Why you want to improve your skills? Because you want not only to sustain your earnings, because you want to grow your earnings. I earned 5 rupees last year. I want to earn 10 rupees this year, maybe 15. I'll be looking forward to 20 next year, right? Did it happen with you? If it didn't happen with you, then actually it is because you have gained very, very great hand at your skills, but you didn't make money out of that. And that is where we need to understand the business aspect of physiotherapy, right? Do you agree that you need to understand the business aspect of physiotherapy? Like if you have made a money, if you have made money out of your skills, but then almost the average every year what you have earned is same, then actually you need to learn the business aspect of physiotherapy, especially if you are into a private practice. Especially if you're planning to expand your services, if you're exactly wanting to replicate your team members. So now let us understand this from a very simple example. Very simple example. And then please, whosoever, one of the participants who are saying no and the participants who are saying yes, now please try to relate to it, because business happens at too many levels, right? So suppose there is, let us understand this mango business, right? Now, there is a mango tree. How many of you have a mango in your courtyard? How many of you have a mango tree in your courtyard, in the backyard? Do you have? Does anyone have? Okay, Dr. Shahbaz. Okay, Dr. Sachin. Yeah, a lot of. Okay, no. Dr. Shraddha has. Okay, so now, what you.